Hi, it's Bob Kraft of TennisMinistry.org, and I'm talking today about Wimbledon and the churches. There are many churches in Wimbledon. Wimbledon is divided into Wimbledon Center, which is kind of the industrial, commercial area, and then there's Wimbledon Village, which are the very expensive homes up the hillside, and Wimbledon Village is just the area that the All England Club is located in. So there are churches in many churches on many corners there. You can find, I would say, at least 20 or 30 churches in that area, and then there are towns nearby too. When I first arrived on the scene back in Wimbledon, at Wimbledon Center and Wimbledon Village, I actually went to probably 10 or 12 churches over a week period because I wanted to find out the churches that were there. I wanted to meet the pastors. I wanted to share about the work that I was doing with the players, and I wanted to see firsthand what the church service was like so that I could give a list of churches to players and also post it on the internet, and then people could have choices of where they wanted to go. You know, for me, it was really not about saying, go to this particular church or this church is the best. I don't feel that way at all. And in fact, your church, you know, I would just love to go there if I could come to your hometown and experience and meet the people who run the church and the people who attend the church. I'm a pastor myself, and I love churches. And so churches on every corner, if you're not really looking for the church as a fan or an umpire or a player, you're probably not going to really recognize them. They're not often with the church with a steeple in a very manner that, you know, it's very obvious that that's a church. There are churches sometimes in smaller buildings, sometimes around the corner, sometimes in commercial centers. There's even a church that met in a movie theater there at Wimbledon Center, a very good church, and I took players there. So what I would just share with you is that go on Google, do Wimbledon churches, and you'll come up with a lot of churches. As I've done a video on one church that I would not recommend, and I've taken them off my list because I don't think they were practicing the right thing, and they belong to an organization called Church of England, which ordains homosexuals, and I didn't feel comfortable with recommending that church to the people that I was reaching out to. Having said that, those churches I've left off, but I would just tell you that you can make your own choice. You find the churches. Don't choose a church just because it's convenient for you or that you see it's on your walking path to Wimbledon Center, for example, or Wimbledon Village, because churches are much different, have different approaches. Sometimes what I look for in a church is I want a church that's authentic. I want a church where people go to, and it's not just a one-hour service or an hour-and-a-half service, and then people finish the service and they go, and that's pretty much it for the whole week. That's a church, to me, that's not alive. You know, I want a church where people go away and they're very active in the church during the weekday. The church doors are open, and people can go there and receive solace and also, you know, help and encouragement, whatever. People are friendly, that it's a community-based church, so you see a lot of children, you see a lot of young people, you see a lot of older people, you see a lot of different mixture of people with different economic backgrounds. I think that's important too, because the gospel is not just for one type of people, it's for everybody. And when I first arrived, I spent that two-day period, I went to many churches to see what they were like. I went to a Korean church, I went to two South African churches, I went to a Japanese church, and the rest of them were English churches. I found a Polish church that was more in London Center, but you know, I was always looking for churches that would fit in with the players because there's many nationalities there. And then not too far away from as you walk by on your way to the All England Club, there's St. Mary's, which is the famous Catholic church. What I would say is, you know, the church that I personally attended there when I was there was called Queens Road Baptist Church. It's next to Wimbledon Center, and it's around behind the shopping mall, so you can easily find it. It's been there for more than 150 years, I think, around that time. It's a family-oriented church. The people are friendly. You'll see many different types of people attending the church. I had a great relationship there with the people, and to still do to this day. Even some members from Wimbledon Club attended that church, and some of the people who worked in the club were there. So, you know, that would be one that I would recommend. But again, I would just leave it up to you. Look for a church. Sunday, they don't start the tournament on the first Sunday. On the middle Sunday, which is coming up in a couple days, they don't have matches unless they're behind on their schedule because of rain. It's only happened once or twice in the history of the championships, as I remember. And then the final Sunday, they play their matches, but the finals. But that's so the players can get to the next tournament, which starts on Monday or Tuesday. I very much respect that the tournament has kept those traditions alive. And also, it's important to remember that the All England Club Championships, also known as Wimbledon, some of the people who won it in the early 1880s were actually pastors and vicars and reverends themselves. The reason that they don't play on Sunday is because they honor their Christian roots. Now, that's not really spoken about much at all anymore, even at all, but that's where it came from, and it's really one of the few tournaments that still does it and has resisted the draw of putting on matches on Sunday for commercial reasons, which is for TV sponsorship and dollars. God knows the All England Club makes enough money in the Wimbledon Championship, so I admire that about the club. On the other hand, it's a great tournament. Enjoy it. If you get a chance, find a church and go there and worship and feel at peace. Pray and meet some of the people. Don't be a loner. Don't sit in the back. Just because you don't know anybody doesn't mean that you can't go up and introduce yourself to the pastor or to some of the people who attend the church. Just say, I'm a visitor, or I'm a player, and I'm just here, and I just want to say hi, and I've enjoyed your church service. That will start a conversation. So enjoy, and hope we meet you sometime in the future.